Well, let's begin with this thought. Nobody performs well under pressure. But a lot of us are tempted to think that we do when we actually don't. We thought that we become more creative when we are under pressure. And you know this is a feeling and not reality. It's true that you might be feeling more productive, but in reality, the products that you create are usually worse. So that pressure that does not kill us does not make us stronger either. Yes, it makes us adjusted to it, but we end up settling for less. And if we settle for less, we are just not growing under pressure. The pressure is really unavoidable and we do not get better in time. We start to have performance issues, constant complaints, failed expectations, and the stress gets chronic. Instead of performing well, we have learned to accept our defeat willingly or unwillingly. Moreover, this uncontrolled amount of pressure leads us nowhere near our destination. Rather, it brings us to depression, insomnia, weakened immune system, and excessive stress eating that leads us to obesity or even heart disease. Not to mention other unhealthy habits we are forced into, such as smoking, abusing drugs, and alcohol. The pressure simply gets the better of us. So well, now we might be left helpless, but not hopeless. The Bible gives us comfort when we are performing under pressure. The Apostle Paul, one of the most successful Christians who has gone through a lot, through thick and thin, he has shared us the secret how to perform well in every circumstances. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 11 and 12, he said that, "For I have learned to be content in whatever circumstances I am. I know both how to have little and I know how to have a lot. In any and all circumstances, I have learned the secret of being content, whether well-fed or hungry, whether in abundance or in need." Now, this is wisdom from a very experienced man who was at the twilight of his career, and he wants every one of us to accomplish what God can and will fulfill in our life in the midst of pressure. Paul was not telling us to be content with the crisis. He did not tell us to back away and let it be. He was telling us to stay on track and not to crack under pressure. He wants us to keep moving forward while learning the secret of a breakthrough. And here it is. You must take back God's place in your heart and taps into your potential in God's presence. And this is the turning point in verse 13. It says, "I am able to do all things through Him who strengthened me." When Jesus takes all of our attention, He becomes our sufficiency. The moment we touch God's transforming power, He gives us strength to endure all, and thus leading us from strength to strength to infinity. For the first time, we are truly performing well under pressure, because now we learn the secret of breaking through, that Jesus wins it all for us because He helped us overcome. So what is the difference a Christian can make when they are performing under pressure? Well, the answer is that these Christians, they are ordinary persons who live by faith in the extraordinary God, and nothing can stop them together from performing well. Here is some wisdom for you today.